Hello everyone, today we'll be looking at the quick solutions to the chemistry section of All India Aakas Test Series JEE Main 2020 Test 9 Code A and B. So let's start with the first question, students. So question number 26. Which of the following statements is true? So option 1, it says the hybridization of carbon in CH2, HCHO and C60 molecule are respectively SP, SP2 and SP3. So students, this is not correct. In the C60 molecule, the hybridization of carbon is SP2 and not SP3, while the other two are correctly matched. CH2 contains carbon in SP hybridization, whereas HCHO contains carbon in SP2 hybridization. Okay, let us look at the second statement now. Dipole moment of NF3 is exactly equal to zero. This is an incorrect statement, students. If we draw the structure of NF3, so it is a polar molecule and the dipole moment is not zero. Let us look at the next option now. Bond order between oxygen atoms in O2 is 2. Okay, and O2 is diamagnetic. This is also not correct, students. O2 is paramagnetic as it contains unpaired electrons in the antibonding molecular orbital. So there is antibonding electron present in the pi star molecular orbital. Okay, let us look at the last option now. Bond angle, which is HNH, in the ammonium ion is greater than that in ammonia. So this is a correct statement, students. In the ammonia, there is a lone pair. So there is a distortion in this molecule and the HNH angle is less than the tetrahedral angle. Whereas in the ammonium ion, the bond angle is exactly equal to 109 degree and 28 minutes. So students, for this question, we have to mark the correct answer as option 4. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 27. Due to the presence of a lone pair on the central atom in hydrides of group 15, they are basic. The correct order of their basic strength is. So students, if we talk about the group 15 hydrides, we know that the basic strength decreases down the group. Okay, so we have ammonia, we have phosphine, we have arsine, and we have stibine. So as we move from top to bottom, the basic nature decreases. Students, if you look at the options which are given to us, we can clearly see that for this question, we have to mark the correct answer as option 2. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 28. Which of the following is the correct statement about the trihalides of group 13 elements? Okay, so if you talk about option 1, the tendency to gain electrons by AlCl3 anhydrous is greater than that of BCl3 anhydrous. This is not correct, students. The charge density over boron is greater, so it has a greater tendency to gain electrons. If you look at the second statement now, students, BF3 forms BF6-3 negative on reaction with NaF. This is not correct, students. The boron, it cannot expand its octet, so it cannot have a valency equal to 6. So this is incorrect, students. Let us look at the third option now, students. Hybridization of aluminium in dimeric form is sp2. So students, examiner seems to be interested in the dimeric form of the trihalide. So alx3 whole twice, let's say. So if I draw the structure, alx3 exists as a dimer. Okay, so this is the structure, students, and we can clearly see that the hybridization of aluminium is sp3 and not sp2. Okay, so the third statement is also not correct, students. If we talk about the fourth option now, hybridization of aluminium in the product obtained by hydrolysis of AlCl3 and acidified aqueous solution is sp3d2. This is a correct statement, students. Upon the hydrolysis of AlCl3 in acidified aqueous solutions, we have the formation of the hexa-coordinated aluminium complex. Okay, students, in this complex, the hybridization of aluminium is sp3d2. Okay, so for question number 28, we have to mark the correct answer as option 4. Let us look at the next question now. Let us look at question number 29 now, students. Consider the following coordination compounds. So we've been given 4 different coordination compounds, students. Which of the following statement is correct for the above compounds? Okay, so the examiner seems to be interested in the optical activity of these 4 compounds, C1, C2, C3 and C4. Okay, so let's start with C1, students. So C1 is CrNO3 whole thrice and NH3 whole thrice. So students, this is optically inactive. So this is of type MA3B3. This is inactive. Okay, let us look at the next option now. So I have K3CoC2O4 whole thrice. Okay, so students, this complex can be written as MAA whole thrice. So this is optically active, students. In this case, there exists a D plus L pair. If I talk about the third complex now, students, so in the third complex, I have MAA2 and B2. Okay, so this is also going to be optically active, students. It will have a sysform and a transform. The transform is going to be optically inactive, whereas this sysform is going to be optically active students. So the sysform is going to exist in a D plus L pair again. If I talk about the last complex, which is complex C4 students, this is of type MAA2BC. So this also has the sysform as optically active. So there exists a D plus L pair for this also. Okay. So let's look at the options which are given to us now, students. Which of the following statement is correct for the above compounds? So option one, it says both C1 and C2 can show optical activity. So this is not correct, students. C1 cannot show optical activity, as we had discussed. Talk about the second statement now. Both C2 and C3 have at least one optically active isomer each. So this is the correct statement, students. Okay, if I talk about the third statement now, both C3 and C4 have two optically active enantiomeric pair each. So this is not correct, students. Both these compounds do not have two optically active enantiomeric pair each. Let us look at the fourth statement now, students. Both C1 and C4 have three geometrical isomers each. So this is also not correct, students. The first complex, which is C1, it consists only two geometrical isomers, which is the meridional and the facial or the Murfac isomers, as it is said. Okay. So students, the fourth statement is also not correct. So out of these given statements, only the second one is correct, students. So for question number 29, we have to mark the correct answer as option 2. Let us move on ahead to the next question. Let us look at question number 30 now, students. In the froth flotation process, NaCN is added to separate PbS and ZnS minerals, in which NaCN is used as depressant. Okay. Consider the following statements. So these statements have been given to us, students, and the examiner seems to be interested in the correct statements among the ones which are given. Okay. So if I talk about this PbS and ZnS minerals, students, so NaCN is added as a depressant. So what this NaCN does is, students, this NaCN, it reacts with ZnS. So the ZnS reacts with NaCN, and students, the complex ZnCN4 2- negative is formed. Okay, so this soluble complex of zinc is formed, whereas lead does not have that much affinity for the cyanide ions. Okay, so they go to the froth, whereas this zinc sulfide, it is not allowed to go to the froth upon addition of NaCN. Okay, so if you look at statement S1, students, PbCN2 is precipitated while there is no reaction with ZnS. This is not correct. If I talk about S2 now, ZnS forms soluble complex Na2ZnCN4. This is a correct statement, students. If I talk about S3 now, PbS forms soluble complex this. This is not correct, students. Lead does not have that much affinity for cyanide ions. If I talk about the fourth statement, NaCN prevents the auto reduction of ZnS. So this is also not correct. So out of these given statements, students, only the second statement is correct. And for this question, we have to mark the answer as option 3. Let us look at the next question now.